Hello guys, welcome back to Uchi Gaming channel. So based on popular demand, in this video I want to showcase Helix, everything about her skills, her ultimate, and what she can do, everything about her in this video. Well, actually I have my own Helix, but I haven't really raised her yet, so I was just going to use a friend Helix to showcase her in this video. Her stats is based on hash rate, yeah, just like any other healer. Her first skill, it is a passive skill. When an ally's HP is lower than 20%, it will cure the HP equivalent to 30% hash rate x original energy stacks and trigger once per battle for each doll. So it has the mechanism similar to the anti-fatal death skill. Yeah, when the ally is about to die, basically Helix will automatically heal that character. Trigger only once per battle. When the battle is over, heal all allies with 60% hash rate x original energy stacks. This treatment will not affected by the battlefield overload effect. So this is another good passive, which after the battle end, Helix will heal all allies. Very very convenient and very very helpful. And the skill number 2, throw the improvement potion to ally with the lowest HP remaining. Heal allies within the range of the potion with 450% hash rate and at a 7-second improvement effect. Every time an ally is treated, it will provide one layer of original energy effect. This original energy is the one that we need for the passive skill, so we can get this from the skill number 2. Improvement, attack and hash rate plus 25%. So other than healing the ally, Helix will also buff the allies with attack and hash rate plus 25%, so it is definitely awesome. The original energy expand the range of the improvement potion by 1 square and can be stacked by 15 times. So basically the more she use the skill number 2, the wider the AoE heal will be. Yeah, her heal is AoE and the healing amount is decent. Without any fancy buffs, the heal can actually reach around 10k HP. So it is a very decent heal. And actually, because of the second skill, she can be used as the one and only healer in the party. And the skill number 3, which is the ultimate, add an activation effect that lasts for 5 seconds to a light doll that previously used the ultimate skill. Temporarily add the ultimate energy, allowing that ally to use ultimate once again. When there is no ultimate skill release or the aligned doll that previously released the ultimate skill died, the skill will not be released temporarily. Activation, attack and hash rate plus 25% and the cooldown of the ultimate skill is refreshed. So another attack and hash rate buff. We can get attack and hash rate plus 25% from this skill number 2 and we can get another attack and hash rate plus 25% from the ultimate. This is definitely awesome. For example, I use Hatsuchiri ultimate and then I use Helix ultimate. Within 5 seconds, I will be able to use Hatsuchiri's ultimate once again for free. That's actually what this ultimate can do. And also by using Helix to trigger Hatsuchiri's ultimate, that Hatsuchiri will be able to get attack plus 25% buff, which is very nice. So that Hatsuchiri's ultimate will be even more painful compared to without Helix ultimate. So let's try to use Helix in this kind of party. I want to use her as the one and only healer. And I will showcase her on the Endless Exploration Floor 400 Stage 6. Yep, as you can see here, Floor 400. Okay, so the first layer's boss. Alright, the Tentacle Lady. So this is going to be a quite tough battle. Yeah, but Helix will be the one and only healer in this party. And she's actually really good because of, I will only use Clue Case ultimate in this battle. Yeah, let's wait. Come on, okay. Now let's use Clue Case ultimate. And then after this, I will use Helix Ultimate so that I can use Kluke's Ultimate once again. That's actually her purpose here, other than to heal the entire party. Okay. Wait. There is a shield right there. I cannot use her ultimate yet. Okay, the shield is gone. Time to use Helix Ultimate. And then let's use Kluke's Ultimate. You can see that Kluke's icon is now blue. So it means I will be able to use Kluke's Ultimate for free. Okay. And that Kluke get hash rate plus 25% when using the ultimate because of Helix buff, which is nice. And you can see that Helix heal, the AoE is really really wide because of the second skill. Look at that. It is like the whole map getting healed by Helix. And this 30k is the heal after the battle end to all allies, which is nice. Look at this. Helix did a lot of heal to the entire party, which is nice. Okay, mini boss battle. Let's try to utilize Kluke and Helix ultimate here. Kluke's ultimate is the most painful in this team, so yeah. By using Helix, I will be able to spam Kluke's ultimate like this. Okay. Helix, heal. Okay. My Kloto is tanking the boss. Heal Kluke. I mean Helix. Oh, the boss is so tough. A little bit more. Okay. Yep. As you can see right there, that Helix somehow made it as the single healer in this party. Yeah. Okay, the second layer's boss. Yeah, let's try to do the same. Let's spam Kluke's ultimate and then Helix. And then Kluke again. Like this. Kluke! Oh, okay. I need to recharge Helix ultimate. Yeah, you have to have 2 bars of ultimate charge so that you can use that combo. Your main DPS ultimate, then Helix. But here, if I want to use Kluke's ultimate once again, actually, it is better to use Helix ultimate than Kluke herself, because if I use Helix ultimate, Kluke will get 25% hash rate boost, which is very nice. Okay, let's wait for the shield to be gone. Okay, let's wait now. Yep, 25% hash rate boost to Kluke. Which means Kluke's ultimate will be more painful. Yeah, look at that Kluke's damage. 1.6 million. Damage already. This one is a quite tough boss. So yeah. If Helix can actually be the one and only healer in this kind of party, it means she is definitely a very very reliable healer. Because her heal are AoE. Yeah, she can basically heal the whole party. Unlike Nanaka, the allies doesn't have to be very close to Nanaka. Yeah, but they can be anywhere as long as they are grouping close enough, like this. So let's use Kluke's again. Boom. Okay. Look at that. My other characters, all of my characters actually still have full HP because of the skill 2 on Helix makes her AoE heal becomes very very large. stack up to 15 layers, which means she can basically heal the whole party now. Yeah, everyone in the map. Look at that, very reliable healer. Isn't that awesome, guys? Yeah. Yep, as you can see, everyone is still alive when I beat the boss. Yeah, Cloquet did 3.3 million damage. So yeah, that is Helix. In my opinion, she is a very, very good healer for both defensive and also offensive. Well, if you are a spender, definitely just get her once she got released in global. But if you are an FTP, maybe you should save for those better DPS and tank in the future, other than getting another healer, because to be honest, even without Helix, your party is still going to be fine. But with Helix, obviously, it will get better, in my opinion. Yeah, so I think that's all. Thank you for watching, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe now if you haven't, and see you next time. Bye, Ushi Punch.